Dear students, good afternoon. In previous class, students, you read about the microorganisms, which are how microorganisms are useful for you and how microorganisms are harmful for you. And after that, you learn how microorganisms create vital role in our environment, because it's having to capacity convert the different gases into different form. So students, today we are going to learn the topic nitrogen cycle. What are you going to learn today? Nitrogen cycle. Dear students, you know the 78% nitrogen is found in our environment in the gaseous form, and also you know the gaseous form nitrogen is not usable form. Plants help to making in suitable form. Why plants are making its suitable form? Because the leguminous plant having the nodules in root, and roots, the nodules having some microorganisms, they having the capacity to convert the atmospheric nitrogen into usable form, gaseous nitrogen in converted into usable form. So students, you see the here the nitrogen cycle. How nitrogen cycle involve in the atmosphere, and how this cycle is useful, converted by the microorganisms and useful for all of us. You know the atmospheric nitrogen by the process of nitrification converted into atmospheric and industrial fixation, by the conversion of atmospheric and industrial fixation, and the process involve nitrification, denitrification, and when go to the atmosphere. Again you see, here you see the protoplasm which is found in the green plant, and here you see protoplasm which is found in the animals. Plants and animals are also dependent upon each other. So the dead and decaying substances are of the plants, and excretory substances of animals converted into the ammonia. By the nitrogen nitrobacter converted into nitriles, and after that converted into nitrates, and again plants are taken. So students, here you see three steps. First step, green plants and animals excreting the ammonia, and these ammonia by the nitrobacter converted into nitriles, and again nitrates, and again used by the plants. After that, these atmospheric nitrogen by the nitrogen fixation converted into ammonia, then go to nitriles, then again go to nitrates, and taken by the plants. After that, third, the atmospheric nitrogen by the process of nitrogen fixation, and atmospheric nitrogen industrial fixation, after that nitrification, after that denitrification, and again go to the atmosphere. So students, you know the 78% nitrogen is found in our environment, 78%, and next thing is the proteins, vitamins, and nucleic acids, it means DNA and RNA. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid,
DNA means deoxyribonucleic acids. Deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA means ribonucleic acid. Ribonucleic acid. Understand, students? So you learn step by step how nitrogen cycle involve in our environment and how the microorganisms play vital role in our environment to convert the atmospheric nitrogen in the usable form. How many percentage? 78% nitrogen where from a part of the many molecules that is essential for you, which is made up of the proteins, nucleic acids and vitamins. Next is the nitrogen is the form either biological process which is used in the alkaloids and the ureas. Next, nitrogen is the essential life form. What is nitrogen? Nitrogen is an essential life form. Once nitrogen is converted by the plants and usable form, it is utilized by the root system. And this process is called the fixing of the nitrogen. First process is the fixing of nitrogen. And second process is the ammonification. Because the plants and animals having the excretory substances and this going to the converted into the ammonia, that is called the ammonification. And third process is the ammonia and form converted into nitrites by the nitrosomonas bacteria. Next factor is another nitrites converted into the nitrates by the bacteria nitrobacter. This is called the nitrification. This process is called the nitrification. And the part of the nitrites and nitrates, that is the nitrites and that is the nitrates, are soil acted upon one another and has a bacteria that is the pseudomonas. Which bacteria involve here in the pseudomonas bacteria? So this process is called the denitrifying of the bacteria. This process is called the denitrifying of the bacteria and this release the nitrogen back to the air. Denitrifying also release free nitrogen back to the air. This process is called the denitrification. This process is called denitrification. So in this way, students, the percentage of the nitrogen remain constant in the atmosphere. So students, what are you learn here? What are the different processes involved? First, nitrogen fixing in atmosphere. Second, ammonification. Third, nitrification, and fourth, denitrification. Four processes are involved. First is the fixing of nitrogen. First is fixing of nitrogen. Second is the ammonification. Third is the nitrification. And fourth is the denitrification. Denitrification. Four processes involved in this system. So students, you learn this topic very carefully, which is useful for all of you. Thank you so much, students.